with the first chapter of export marketing. This is for TYBCOM semester 5. So the first chapter is basics of export marketing. Now, as the name suggests, what is export? Export is anything which we sell outside our country boundaries. That is anything outside India. Will be called as export. So for example, if India is selling goods or services, this is not just about goods, this is about services as well. So if India is providing services to anyone outside India, or goods, it is selling goods to anyone outside India, that transaction will be known as export transaction. Okay, so India will, for example, India is selling goods to US or Japan, etc. This will be known as export marketing. Now, if Maharashtra is selling goods to Gujarat, this is internal marketing. This is not external marketing. That is, this will not be considered as export marketing. Export marketing is only selling goods to countries outside India. Anything selling goods as well as providing services will be considered as export marketing. Okay, now since we are learning what is export marketing, we should also know the features of export marketing. So there are few points which you have to remember in while writing the answer for features of export marketing. It can also be called as characteristic of export marketing. So the mnemonic to remember the points is, limited trips. The mnemonic to remember the answer for features of export marketing or characteristic of export marketing is limited trips. So the first point, that is L. L is, it is large scale operation. Export marketing is done on a large scale basis. Ek ya do unit, 10 ya 20 unit bechne ke liye export marketing nahi hota hai. It will be very costly for a person to export just 10 or 20 or we might say even 100 units of goods. It would be very costly for that person to sell only 100 units of goods to US or Japan, etc. Anyone outside India. So it should always be done on a large scale basis. It should be always done on large scale basis. It is a large scale product. It should be done on a huge scale. Ek saath 1 lakh unit of product is sold or 2 lakhs unit of product is sold, or services given for a long term basis. That is, ek ya do mahine ke liye service dene ke liye koi export nahi karega. It has to be for a longer period of time. For example, 6 months or 8 months, like that. It has to be on a large scale basis. So the first feature of export marketing is large scale basis. That is large scale basis or large scale operations also we can say. Okay. There is one more objective why it is done on a large scale operation, because you will always get a bulk discount. Aap kabhi bhi Crawford market ya waise wholesale market mein gaye ho, agar wahan gaye ho na, to aapko pata chalega that if you take 1 dozen of pen, they will ask you to pay a little less. If you ask for just 1 or 2 pen, they will charge you more. For example, I always buy cello gripper. So actually cello gripper ka bhav abhi market mein is 8 rupees. But if I buy it on bulk, this is per pen I am talking about. Per pen. So if you buy it in bulk, that is if you buy more than 12 units of pen, that is 12 pen or 100 pen or 200 pen, the overall cost, the average cost per pen will come down to 6.5 or 7, which is cheaper for me. So I should always think that if I go on a large scale basis, this is more. This is 12 to 30 pens I'm talking about. So if you always go for a bigger transaction, for a bulk transaction, if you demand for a bulk units, you will get the discount. So export marketing will also provide you a bulky discount, which is an advantageous point for us. So it should be always done on a large scale basis, or else there is no point of exporting. You should better stay in India and sell it in local market, in domestic market. Now, if I'm selling this on a bulk basis, my transport cost will also get divided. अगर 10 यूनिट बेचती हूँ तो भी मेरा ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट विल बी 100 रुपीज़, और अगर मैं 1 लाख यूनिट्स भी बेचती हूँ, माई ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू बी 100 रुपीज़ ओनली. सो इट इज़ ऑलवेज बेटर टू सेल ऑन अ बल्क बेसिस, सो दैट माई ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट विल गेट डिवाइडेड इन ऑल द यूनिट्स एंड माई प्रोडक्ट विल गेट चीपर. आई कैन एड ऑन द प्रॉफिट टू माई कॉस्ट एंड ऑन मोर प्रॉफिट. सो लार्ज स्केल ऑपरेशन, सो लार्ज स्केल, so selling on large scale basis or on a large scale operation is always important in export marketing. So the first point was large scale basis operation. The second point, that is I is, it is a continuous and systematic process. Now why export marketing is a continuous and systematic process? For example, I have thought of selling a rainy season cream. Abhi summer season cream, winter season cream aata rehta hai. I have decided I want to sell rainy season क्रीम. तो अभी रेनी सीजन के लिए क्रीम बेचना है, तो क्या मैं डायरेक्ट बनाना शुरू कर दूँ? आई विल स्टार्ट मेकिंग द प्रोडक्ट एंड आई विल स्टार्ट सेलिंग इट. मुझे पता तो होना चाहिए हु विल बी द कस्टमर्स हु वॉन्ट टू बाय इट, विल देयर बी एनी कस्टमर्स हु वॉन्ट टू यूज़ इट और नॉट, इफ़ दे आर गोइंग टू यूज़ इट हाउ लॉन्ग दे विल यूज़ इट, कि एक बार यूज़ किया, ट्राई किया, अच्छा नहीं अच्छा है, दे विल स्टॉप यूजिंग इट. सो इफ़ आई वॉन्ट टू थिंक ऑफ अ प्रोडक्ट come up in the market and sell those things in the market, it is always important for me to go through a systematic process. What is the systematic process? First, I have to look for the market. That is, I have to research. मुझे market research करना पड़ेगा. कौन buy करेगा? क्या buy करोगे कि नहीं? Whenever you go in a mall ना, they generally अभी आजकल बहुत चालू हो गया. They give you this small checklist. Even when you call these just dial people, they will ask you, ma'am, आपने last time इस चीज़ का rating मांगा था, आप मुझे बता सकते हो from 1 to 5 where you will rate it. They always do it with me. Whenever I'm in hurry, I call just dial for the number. I don't go on net and surf and everything. I always call them and ask them, जल्दी मुझे number दो, I want it quick. That time only they'll ask me, last time you had called for Pizza Hut, tell me where you will score it, 1 to 5, etc. So why they do this? This is their technique of market research. आपको हमेशा पूछते भी है, आप वोडाफोन का सिम कार्ड यूज़ करते हो या आइडिया का करते हो, अरे तुझे क्या है, मैं कोई भी यूज़ करूँ. बट दिस इज़ देयर मार्केट रिसर्च स्किल, दिस इज़ हाउ दे रिसर्च थिंग्स. सो सिमिलरली इन माई एग्जाम्पल, आई सेड आई एम गोइंग टू सेल अ रेनी सीजन क्रीम. सो फर्स्ट आई हैव टू आस्क पीपल, विल यू यूज इट और नॉट, आर यू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डू यू यूज क्रीम, इफ़ यू यूज क्रीम विल यू यूज इट इन रेनी सीजन. I have to tell them the advantages and disadvantages of the cream, that आप use करोगे तो आपको ज़्यादा wetty wetty नहीं लगेगा, etc. So these are the techniques you have to follow while introducing your product in the market. So first I'll research in the market, then I will produce the product, then I will calculate the cost of it, कि मुझे कितना profit होगा. अगर 10 रुपये की cream मुझे पड़ रही है और मैं सिर्फ 11 में बेच रही हूँ, 1 रुपये profit is very less. So I have to think other ways to reduce the cost. So that is what this particular feature is telling you, that export marketing is a continuous and a systematic process. It needs a continuous approach. It always आपने क्रीम बेच भी दी, यू ऑलवेज हैव टू आस्क फॉर फीडबैक. अपने इंडिया में फीडबैक सिस्टम बहुत कम है. वेन एवर यू गो अब्रॉड दिल ऑलवेज आस्क यू फॉर फीडबैक, वेदर इट इज़ अ सर्विस और अ गुड. वंस यू यूज द गुड दिल ऑलवेज आस्क हाउ वॉज इट, डिड यू लाइक इट, डू यू वॉन्ट एनी इम्प्रूवमेंट्स, डू यू वॉन्ट इट इन अ बॉटल और यू वॉन्ट इट इन अ पाउच और यू वॉन्ट इट इन अ ट्यूब. ऐसे सब भी पूछते, यहाँ किसी को पढ़ी नहीं इंडिया में, नो बडी केयर्स. दे जस्ट दे ऑल दे वॉन्ट टू डू इज मेक मनी. दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द advantages of asking for feedback and understanding how important consumers' views are. Okay, so coming back, it is a continuous and systematic process. You have to know how things work out. So second feature is it should be a continuous and systematic process. Third, that is M is marketing of goods and services. As I said, अगर आपको पता नहीं है कि आपका गुड्स या सर्विस का कोई मार्केट है, अगर मार्केट है तो आप उसको कैसे अप्रोच करोगे, आप उसको कैसे ढूंढोगे. सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू नो हाउ टू मार्केट, हाउ टू पब्लिश योर प्रोडक्ट इन द मार्केट सो दैट पीपल विल अट्रैक्ट टूवर्ड्स इट एंड टेक इट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, या फॉर एग्जाम्पल product called as roti maker, अपने इंडिया में भी ये product है but people don't use it. In abroad, Indians who are in abroad, they use this roti maker, क्योंकि हर किसी को रोटी बनानी नहीं आती, हर किसी को बेलन चलाना नहीं आता, चूल्हे पर सेकना नहीं आता. Whereas here people always prefer to make roti by hand. तो इंडिया में रोटी मेकर नहीं चला, पर अब्रॉड में रोटी मेकर चला. व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज यू हैव टू मार्केट योर प्रोडक्ट इन सच प्लेस वेयर देयर इज डिमांड. इंडिया में रोटी मेकर को तुम कितना भी फ्री में भी बेचो, कोई आके नहीं लेगा, बिकॉज देयर इज ऑलवेज अ मेंटालिटी, मम्मी गरम गरम बना के देगी ना, मम्मी उस पर मस्त घी लगा के देगी ना, देयर इज ऑलवेज, यहाँ पे किसी को कड़क चाहिए, किसी को सॉफ्ट चाहिए. अब्रॉड में ये सब नहीं होता, दे डोंट नो ओनली हाउ टू मेक रोटी, वेन हाउ विल दे मेक कड़क एंड सॉफ्ट रोटी. सो सिमिलरली रोटी मेकर इज अ प्रोडक्ट विच दे मार्केटेड इन अब्रॉड और चला, इट वॉज अ सक्सेसफुल प्रोडक्ट, बट इन इंडिया इट डेंट वर्क आउट वेरी वेल. प्लस इंडिया में देर इज अ मेंटालिटी कि रोटी मेकर क्यों लाने की ज़रूरत है, यू कैन मेक इट एट होम, इट इज़ ईजियर, इट इज़ फास्टर, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. सो थर्ड फीचर विल बी मार्केटिंग ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज. या सो हियर यू हैव टू फिक्स योर टारगेट. इफ माई टारगेट is US, I have to fix my target in US and I have to introduce my product in a right place at right time and with a right price also. US में rupees में नहीं बेच सकते तुम, US में dollar में बेचना पड़ता है, वो भी apt dollar, sensible dollars में बेचो. ऐसा नहीं कि $100 का रोटी मेकर, पागल है क्या, $100 का रोटी मेकर कोई नहीं लेगा. इंस्टेड दे विल गो फॉर अ कोचिंग क्लास, लर्न हाउ टू मेक रोटीज एंड देन मेक रोटी एट होम. सो नोबडी इज गोइंग टू बाय रोटी मेकर फॉर $100. यू हैव टू कीप इट एट अ राइट प्राइस ऑल्सो. ओके, नाउ फोर्थ विल बी, दैट इज आई, fourth will be identification and satisfaction of needs and wants. Identification and satisfaction of needs and wants. Now what this particular point is saying is you have to first identify the needs. पहले पता करो कि आपका market कौन सा है, what is the target. If you are planning to make a chocolate, you can't go to senior citizen group and ask कि आपको chocolate पसंद आएगा कि नहीं. Your target market should be small kids, younger kids maximum. So you have to first decide what is the, first identify your target market and then know what is their needs, what do they expect from a chocolate or what do they expect from a product. इसका best example देना चाहो तो McDonald's, you all must have gone to McDonald's. Now McDonald's यहाँ का नहीं है, it's abroad, it's an MNC company, but वहाँ पे अब जाओगे ना तो आपको पनीर या स्पाइसी चिकन ये सब नहीं मिलेगा. अब्रॉड पीपल डोंट हैव स्पाइसी फूड, दे हैव वेरी ब्लैंड फूड, बट इंडियन पीपल हैव स्पाइसी फूड. तो मैकडॉनल्ड्स ने क्या किया, दे आइडेंटिफाइड द नीड्स ऑफ पीपल इन इंडिया एंड इंट्रोड्यूस्ड अ प्रोडक्ट which is suitable to us, that is we have spicy food, so they made spicy food. आप US के McDonald's में जाके पनीर टिक्का मांगोगे ना आपको नहीं मिलेगा, क्योंकि वहाँ पर ये प्रोडक्ट बिकता ही नहीं है. नोबडी हैज़ इट, नोबडी हैज़ स्पाइसी थिंग और पनीर एंड एवरी थिंग वेज वाला. सिमिलरली सबवे हैज़ इंट्रोड्यूस दिस फ्यू वेज वेजीज विच इज़ सोल्ड ओनली इन इंडिया. Continuing, I was giving an example of McDonald's and Subway. तो McDonald's यहाँ पे पनीर और स्पाइसी चीज़ें बेचता है. सेम चीज़ इज़ नॉट सोल्ड इन US. सिमिलरली Subway people also have introduced veg products in India because यहाँ पे market है, यहाँ पे veg चीज़ों के खाने की demand है. अब्रॉड US में नहीं है तो उन लोग वहाँ पे नहीं बेचते, यहाँ पे बेचते हैं. ओके, सो द इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर इन एक्सपोर्ट मार्केटिंग इज दैट फर्स्ट यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई एंड देन सेटिस्फाई द नीड्स ऑफ पीपल एंड नो व्हाट यू आर सेलिंग. सिमिलरली मेड सिस्टम ऑनलाइन, इफ़ यू रजिस्टर योर सेल्फ, दिस पर्टिकुलर कंपनी विल सेंड यू मेड आपके घर के काम करने के लिए, झाड़ू है, पोछा है, बर्तन है, कपड़े है, एक्सेट्रा. नाउ दिस डजेंट वेरी वेल वर्क इन इंडिया बट इट डेफिनेटली वर्क्स इन अब्रॉड. देयर दे गिव यू दिस हेल्प सर्विसेज, इट इज़ कॉल्ड एज हेल्प सर्विसेज. सो देयर इफ़ यू रजिस्टर योर सेल्फ इन दिस पर्टिकुलर कंपनी वेयर दे विल गिव यू सर्विसेज, दे विल हेल्प यू विद दी सर्विसेज, दे कैन, you can register yourself there. So this is a kind of service which doesn't work in India but it definitely works in abroad. So again you have to understand the needs and wants of customers and then introduce your product in the market so that it works very well. So one example I gave is of service and the other was of goods or products, that is McDonald's or Subway. Okay, so the fourth point is identification and satisfaction of needs and wants of customers. So I is done, then T is for three-faced competition. Now I am an exporter, that is I am in India. So I'm in India, I'm selling goods in USA and there is one more country, that is for example China, who is selling good in USA. So I have three competitions. The first competition is exporters in India. Ek to main hoon. For example Mr. X is already selling goods to US. Now there will be other people also who might want to sell products to USA, the same product. So there can be Y, Z, A, etc. So these are the people who will be my competitors. So first competition is people in my country, exporters in exporters country. Here I am the exporter because I am exporting goods to USA. So competitors of exporters country itself, that is India's exporter, other exporters. Second will be USA ke local people. For example, if I am selling shampoos, that is Himalaya, take the product as Himalaya. I'm selling Himalaya shampoo, whereas local residents in USA might also sell shampoos like L'Oreal hai, Tresemme hai, etc. So even those will be my competitors. I have to beat them and sell my product. And the third will be other exporter countries, that is China. China ka bhi koi XYZ product hoga jo un log bechte honge. So the one more feature of export marketing is you have to face three-faced competitors. That is one, people in exporter's country, two, local people in importer country. Here USA is importer India is exporter, USA is importer. So local importer residents will also be my competition, and the other exporter companies also. Thodi na ban hai, sirf India or USA mein hi thodi agreement ho sakta hai. Baki logo mein bhi sale or purchase ka agreement ho sakta hai. So I have three-faced competition. So this is one of the features. Other is E. E is for exchange regulations. Now, it is simpler to sell product in India, in domestic market. Exchange regulation. It is simpler for me to sell product in domestic market. Agar mujhe Gujarat mein sell karna hai, ya Hyderabad, ya Chennai, etc., etc. If I want to sell in India itself, there are no huge restrictions. But when it comes to export marketing, that I have exchange regulations, payment proceedings, ya received, paisa hamesha mostly foreign currency mein hota hai. So these are few things you have to take care of in export marketing, that is exchange regulations. And if you are an exporter, you have to be aware of these rules and regulations also. You have to be aware of the policies and procedures, jaise ke licenses lena, permission lena, time pe export karna, credit period, etc., etc. So you have to be aware of all the rules and regulations, policies and procedures. Now, D. D is for dominance of MNC. MNC is nothing but multinational companies. Now, multinational companies is बहुत सारी जगह पे उसके branches होते हैं. For example, I just gave you an example of McDonald's, Subway, etc. So, the leading MNCs are USA, Japan, and Europe. The leading MNCs are USA, Japan, and Europe. You have to remember this because this might come in your objective type questions. So the dominance of MNC is, for taking McDonald's and Subway ka example only, what do this McDonald's and Subway do? They don't produce it there and then they send it here. They produce it here only and they sell it also here. As I said, जो पनीर टिक्का वाला बर्गर है वो उन लोग सिर्फ इंडिया में बेचते, तो उन लोग ऐसा नहीं करेंगे यूएस में बना के फिर यहाँ भेजो और फिर यहाँ पे बेचो. इट इज़ अ फूड प्रोडक्ट, यू कैन डू दैट. व्हाट दे डू, दे मेक इट हियर एंड देन दे सेल इट आल्सो हियर. सो इट इज़ ईजियर फॉर देम, प्लस कॉस्ट वाइज भी सस्ता हो जाता है. देयर प्रॉफिट मार्जिन इज ऑल्सो मेंटेन्ड. हेंस dominance of MNC creates a problem for the new exporters to come in the field. अगर यूएस वाला मैकडॉनल्ड्स और सबवे यहाँ पे बेच रहा है तो साइमल्टेनियसली जंबो किंग वाला का प्रोडक्शन बंद हो जाता है या कम हो जाता है. क्यों? पीपल स्टार्ट गोइंग टू हैव बर्गर्स एंड देन दे डोंट हैव द वड़ा पाव विच वी सेल इन इंडिया. सो इट इज़ इंडियन इम्पोर्टर्स के लिए, सॉरी इंडियन प्रोड्यूसर्स के लिए दिस बिकम्स अ लिटिल प्रॉब्लम. Where USA people, that is abroad people, come in India, make food, sell it cheaper than what we produce it here and earn more profit than what we deserve. Okay, so dominance of MNC is a little problem when it comes to export marketing. Then T is for trade barriers. Now there are few type of trade barriers. For example, abhi recently I had Christmas ke time pe I was with one of my friends. She wanted to buy a Santa Claus ka dress. To kya hua na, hum log shopkeeper ke paas gaye that we want to buy a Santa Claus dress. So he said there are two Santa Claus dresses, which one you want? So we said why two, what is the difference? So one person said you will get at 250 one Santa Claus dress and other will be at 2500. I was like why itna difference kyun hai, ek to 250 mein bech rahe ho. और दूसरा डायरेक्ट 2500, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस? क्या करना है, वैसे भी एक ही दिन पहनना है सेंटा क्लॉज का ड्रेस, इतना कौन खर्चेगा? सो वी आस्क्ड व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस, ही सेड 250 वाला कम्स फ्रॉम चाइना एंड 2500 इज मेड इन इंडिया. We all know how China products are, it how famous China products are, but they are simultaneously so cheap कि अगर आपको ऐसा लगे भी कि आपको China product buy नहीं करना, then also you will always go and buy the China product because it is cheaper than what the India is producing. So if this is happening, India is at loss because कोई इंडिया का product कभी नहीं खरीदेगा because China तो सस्ते माल ही बेचता है and it is always lucrative for a person to go for a cheaper price than go for quality. ये इंडिया का mentality, अगर cheaper और quality में you have to choose, you'll always go for a cheaper product, you'll never go for a quality product. Anyway, Santa Claus dress में quality as such कुछ है नहीं, एक दिन पहनना है, cheap तो cheap, एक दिन पहनना है, मेरा काम हो रहा है, but still see the difference, how huge the difference is. So what India is going to do, India will make a trade barrier. Barrier is obstruction. This is India, this is China. India will make a trade barrier and obstruction. अभी ये trade barrier और obstruction कोई physical trade barrier नहीं है. This will be in terms of money. Money how? We will give a higher percentage of duty on China products. और actual में China products पे 100 to 150 percentage of duty extra लगता है. Yes, it is 100 to 150 percentage of duty. So actually speaking, this 250 is after imposing that heavy duty. So just imagine, अगर वो duty नहीं लगता तो ये for sure 100 rupees में बेचता ये चाइना वाला बंदा, for sure after earning a good amount of profit. So ये after imposing that huge amount of profit, the China is selling at 250, or else it would have definitely sold at 100 rupees. So what I'm trying to say is there has to be trade barrier so that India won't suffer. Similarly, China products ke saath everyone is मतलब everyone has a problem, may it be USA people, may it be Japan people, may it be European people, everybody has a problem with China product because they give it on a lot cheaper basis. Hence everybody imposes this trade barrier कि अगर चाइना से आप प्रोडक्ट इंपोर्ट कर रहे हो आपको इतना परसेंट एक्स्ट्रा ड्यूटी लगेगा. स्टिल पीपल प्रिफर चाइना प्रोडक्ट्स बिकॉज दे आर एनी डे चीपर देन व्हाट यू सेल और प्रोड्यूस इन इंडिया. सो ट्रेड बैरियर शुड बी देयर. Then there are few rules and regulations which you have to follow. There are few rules and regulations which one has to follow. These rules and regulations will be nothing but restrictions. What will be the restrictions? Restrictions regarding the risk. Restriction is regarding the risk. Risk as in political risk. And commercial risk. These are few risk one has to go through if that person is introducing himself or herself in export marketing field. What would be the political risk? Political risk can be not stable political scenario of that country, or not stable political scenario of that country, या तो फिर it is on a point of breaking a war.